back into the game, boys. But just beforehand, I do need to run a commercial because, of course, CSGO Lounge are promoting this and indeed sponsoring this tournament. So take it away. I'm not sure who said that the force buying's part of their strats, but dude, I've casted E-Frag probably 20 or 30 times. And the amount of times that force buying has screwed them hard is unbelievable. So if it's part of their tactics, I'm hoping that they kind of grow out of that a tiny bit. Stream keeps buffering for me. Guys, if you're having any issue with the stream whatsoever, black screens, lag, stuttering, anything like that, just try refreshing. Hopefully that will fix the stream for you. Hopefully it will help matters. If that doesn't work, I'm kind of out of ideas. Yeah, Fodder, they really do struggle with that. And if the guy who typed it in, I'm sorry, I didn't quite see your name, man. The chat went down way too fast. But if it's part of their strats, then I feel like maybe something needs to change, because it is costing them a lot of games. Why isn't the stream 60 FPS? Because my PC is not good enough. Quite simply put, I just stepped in last minute today, guys, so you could get a stream. If you guys want to send me PC parts, feel free to do so. We get some 60 FPS streams up in this. Either way, though, I think we are ready to jump live into the knife round here between TSM and E-Frag. And not necessarily the most important knife round in the world. I mean, Dust 2, I feel, slightly T-sided, but nothing too serious. A lot of teams, after winning the knife, will elect to go the CT side anyway, so I don't feel this is as important as the likes of Inferno. And by the way, speaking of Inferno, that will be our third map if we need it this evening. That is the decisive map, or the deciding map, I should say. And I got that weird bug. So yeah, they elect to stay, the TSM, so they're going to be starting on the CT side. So you've heard what I said before, that I feel that TSM should win this, and they should probably win this 2-0. But what are your predictions, guys, in chat? Give me a shout. Do you think E-Frag have a chance at actually causing an upset today? Do you think E-Frag can take a map away from TSM? And if so, which of the three maps would you say? Considering that Dust2 is picked by E-Frag, Overpass by TSM, and then Inferno, as I said before, is the decider if you have just joined us. But that's all the information caught up on. Here we go, live into the game between these two. TSM been having a bit of a rocky affair recently. Last night they didn't play particularly well, managed to scrape the win, but definitely not convincingly. But dupreeh with the USP just reigns in, lands himself two shots. Very nicely done. USP one taps are real. They do get a return frag, but it's not a quick explosion onto the site, as I'm sure they were hoping, and therefore it lets TSM get themselves back through mid, and now they are just smothering this B side, which is about to get planted on from E-Frag. Player coming up from behind. Viktor could be in a spot of bother here if he keeps looking down into lower. His spidey senses are tingling. A cajunb, who made no noise, gets completely caught off guard from Viktor. He seemed to have a sixth sense there. The kill still coming back and forth. It's all on karrigan. He's tapping across and can't get anything done. And E-Frag, even though they lost the first two players in this round, just getting wrecked from dupreeh's USP, they still win the round nonetheless. So the Glock train was real. And TSM will be bitterly disappointed with that result, because I really did think that would be a simple, simple round for them. Vector, indeed. The good old Vector. So here we go. Round number two. That grenade does so much damage. Viktor and NKL were just stood there, and it ripped both of them. Zipnex does land the first shot with the CZ, but my goodness, that nade did about 100 damage just by itself. Ridiculous. And just like that, E-Frag on the back foot. Yes, they still have the weapon advantage. Yes, they still have the grenades in their back pocket as well. But TSM pretty solid when it comes to pistols. They go for the peek and, well, karrigan did get some vital information. That's the two players are pushing his location. There's spyleadeR who will get the kill. Viktor getting the assist there. And another CT player goes for a peek. So again, first frag goes down for TSM. And it would appear that E-Frag are going to clean things up nicely. Although this time around, you can't really blame them. It's effectively pistols and armor versus full weapons. That being said, though, E-Frag are taking this one slow. And dupreeh spots himself a player up mid, can't get anything done, dropped to 1 HP. Device trying to hold the angle here on short, but the problem is that the smoke is just about to dissipate, and in doing so, this leaves his back very vulnerable. He's caught between a rock and a hard place, and there really is nothing he could have done there. So dupreeh, with a Deagle and Kevlar, 1 HP, no grenades, no defuse kit, no reason for him to even try and risk this weapon. I feel like he may just try and save this for round 3. Can't see health. That should fix it. My apologies. There's always a bug whenever I cast and stream, man. Every time. That should have fixed it by pressing escape. Do give me a shout if you have any more issues, guys. Some of you saying that the game sound is too low. Farley, if you're still here, you let me know. I know you. You're not going to troll me. Either way, dupreeh is going to be able to save his Deagle. I believe they're not really filtering out and chasing him down too hard. So that Deagle and Kevlar could be instrumental in round number 3 if it starts to get some frags off. Thank you. You're welcome. Thanks for letting me know, by the way. I appreciate the info. So here we go. TSM not going to be buying up, of course, if they force bought the last round. And a lot of the burden is going to be on dupreeh's shoulders. They go for the short perk. And he is going to be looking for this right now. And he's going to get so much information. No one's even remotely there. But NKL peeks from lower tunnels. Last 2 headshots. Ridiculous. And Viktor as well. And it's looking a bit ominous for TSM in this round. Again, not expecting anything. And it seems this is going to be a clean sweep. Or is it? cajunb lands the first Deagle. Going to be moving in and gets himself fragged. Game sounds a bit low. Turn up game sound just a tad. You sound like a machine. Brilliant. Brilliant. One sec. Just so you guys don't see the IP, because tournaments are typically quite annoyed when you show the IP. So I just turned the gamer sound up a little bit. Do keep me informed, guys, please. Thank you very much. Either way, TSM are going to have themselves some weapons in this round, including an AWP and 4 M4s. And 2 players stacking on the A side on long. So by and large, a fairly standard round here from E-Frag. Typically, terrorists are not going to be poking or probing too quickly. They're going to be looking for the information. Maybe they can get a pick somewhere around the minute mark. Bubble still with a scout, which is a pretty decent weapon on this map, in all honesty. You can still get a lot done. Smokes and flashes landing down, but dupreeh's by himself. No one else had the crossfire there. It's just a case of the strength in numbers from E-Frag. And just like that, not just a frag, but they should be able to get this bomb planted as well. So what did TSM do from this point? They're just backing away. They're going to try and save these weapons, but in doing so, spyleadeR's there. And he delivers the fatal blow onto Zipnix. And E-Frag now will be taking themselves another round. It was very surprising to me to see how quickly TSM decided, screw this noise. Let's just try and save these weapons. Probably will be able to keep these 3 alive and kicking for the next round, judging by E-Frag's positioning. But this does give E-Frag a 4-0 lead on their choice of map. And a map that TSM are renowned for being very powerful on. As some of you guys in chat are saying, though, this map probably slightly TC-sided. A lot of people would agree with that. Additionally, it's still early days, right? TSM are known for having great resilience, great tenacity, so it's not a great start for them, but it's still a long way to go for TSM. And because they did save them 3 players, they're able to rebuy, replenish the weapons, replenish the grenades, and they have another healthy buy here. Issue is, if they lose this round, they will be back into eco. So this is a pretty important round for TSM. They have lost a player. No one checks the pit. That is, oh, catastrophe for E-Frag. cajunb from pit locks now, not just 1, but 2. And that frees karrigan up to just keep his sights trained on short. He doesn't have to worry about long anymore. Now that cajunb has died, they know where spyleadeR's position is. Of course, he is the last remaining E-Frag player. And I can't stress enough how huge that cajunb play was. If he dies, karrigan probably doesn't get the frag onto short as a result of that. And the dominoes could have very well fallen a completely different way. But TSM, I said how important that round was, and they do pick it up. E-Frag, though, have had a lot of success. Very few players killed so far. So easy rebuy for them as well. So TSM not out of the woods just yet. They're going to have to keep battling right here, right now. Still an open play for Karrigan. Smoke down into mid. That stops the vision from the CTs. This looks like a lot of action is about to ensue for Device, who will be pulling himself back. That grenade does a lot of damage. Here comes the flashbang. He's just holding his position, but he gets chased down from E-Frag. It's Viktor that goes in first. This is such aggression from E-Frag once again. And dupreeh, hiding behind the site, begging for dear life, will be taken down. And again, in the blink of an eye, the round just convincingly goes the way of E-Frag. And once again, a bit of deja vu here. TSM have no interest in clutching this. They just want to keep these weapons. And I said before about the importance of this round for them in terms of the economy. If they lose it, they'll probably be screwed. So it's important they save these three weapons. Spyleader does go in looking for that spray. Can't get too much connected, but he still has 78%. So he's happy enough to sit here for now. Karrigan, in the meanwhile, is going to try and hold down the site side and KO with a beautiful one-tap onto Karrigan. No AWP for you, good sirs. In actual fact, E-Frag could pick that up if they want to. Zipnex is pretty low, down to 6 HP. Can they charge him down? Can they chase him down? Yes, they can! Just cajunb survives. And now, you can see the problem. Their money is absolutely screwed. They went four rounds. They had four rounds round loss bonus. They win a round. They've just cancelled it out. And therefore, it forces dupreeh into a Deagle Kevlar, an M4 Kevlar for cajunb, and everybody else, by and large, coming into this round naked. The cajunb, not too deterred by that fact, lands himself a frag. Problem is, that's not good enough for the CT, so hoping he maybe would have landed a 2 or 3 to give him a real shot at this round. Dreamer with beautiful spray control. Very nicely done. And E-Frag positioning themselves for a 6-1. Bomb will be planted for catwalk sides. Finally just by himself, though. And hold the phone for a second, Device. I was going to say, Spyleader on 13 HP was one bullet away from death, so who knows, maybe if Device gets himself up there, lands the second frag, that's a 2-on-2 with the bomb planted. TSM maybe could have caused an upset, but it's unlikely. Dupreeh lasts from remaining player, gets the drop onto Spyleader. Problem is, he has no defuse kit, and again, that bomb really not planted in his favour whatsoever. Two flashes down, and so does dupreeh, falls to his death. I smell like beef. Alright, Red Sub, that's information I definitely needed to know. Thank you for that update. I appreciate it. I hear the shower's pretty handy for that. So I've heard. Force buy up from TSM. You can see no defuse kits, very few grenades. Playing for the frags, really, and you can see from the positions they're quite aggressive here. Yes, they haven't really peaked too much, but that's what I'm talking about. Karrigan goes for the very aggressive peak, lands one frag, can't get a second. Cajunb holding the angle here. It's a pretty decent angle when you don't have grenades. It's not one that you maybe expect from E-Frag's perspective. The fact that TSM have picked up the first kill allows them to bolster mid a tiny bit more. Just leave the one player on B side by himself. Cajunb does get the trade. Problem is, though, that Bubble comes in right afterwards and takes down Karrigan. And it would appear that, again, A site is pretty open. They're going to throw the bomb across the Bubble so he can get that planted for his team. 3-on-3 situation. Device, that's a key frag. Buys him a little bit more time. E-Frag just trying to hold on. See them from their positions. Both players have AWPs. That's not necessarily the greatest place to be in. But they are holding pretty good angles. Dreamer misses the first one. This is a key frag. If he kills this, he can focus his attention onto the site. And he's done just that. It's now on Zipnex. He comes up. And he gets picked off from Bubble. And a 3v2 retake is completely unsuccessful. Shut down with authority from E-Frag. And I think they dropped one of those AWPs to pick up an AK-47 as well. Which is completely understandable. You don't necessarily want to take too many AWPs, especially when you know that the enemy likely is on an eco. It's a very stationary weapon, almost like a turret in a lot of senses. So Let's see if E-Frag can get much done here. Cajunb is moving around the corner. Spyleader picks up the first frag. Going to be coming up right now. Spyleader lands another one. Unbelievable stuff here from E-Frag. And GoTV is going insane. Or is it just Spyleader? Sometimes they get this bug where certain players get really laggy and other ones don't. GoTV is great like that. Either way, wasn't eco around for TSM. Nice shot from Bobble as well. Although he did know where dupreeh was. Man, a lot of people are jumping the gun here. So what do you reckon? You think that TSM already out with this? Judging by some of the comments that I just quickly browsed, like, for a second, a lot of people saying rip skins. Thanks, Nevermore. I appreciate that, bro. I think, guys, take into consideration, it's still early days. It's still very early days. And I think that E-Frag, this is my personal feeling, I don't know if you guys agree with it or not, but I feel that E-Frag are a better T side than they are a CT side, especially in maps like this. So TSM can definitely pull this one back. 100%, I feel. E-Frag, no doubting though that E-Frag have turned up the better of the teams today so far. They have been shifting through the gears at an accelerated rate. Zipnix, be looking for that catwalk play. Victor going to heap around the corner. Just meets device. That's a pretty key frag. Now he can scurry away back to the site and help out dupreeh, who's consistently been on B by himself. Another frag for device. He goes back for a re-peek, looking for the information. I understand why he goes for that, because they're so secluded on the B side. And now dupreeh by himself. 3-on-3. This would be a horrible round again for TSM to lose, considering they got the first frags on the border. 2-on-3. Karrigan lands the shot onto Spyleader. Very nicely done by him, but the bomb's been planted. And again, no defuse kits, no nades, and also no armor for Karrigan. So a single bullet, and his aim's going to go all over the place. What is going on? Dreamer's by himself there. He just gets picked off from behind. This must be a facepalm moment where he's like, dude, where was the cover? The flash comes in. KJB's not holding on to this one. Bubble goes for the re-peek, and he gets picked off. This is going to be very close, but KJB may very well have this one. Hold on to your butt cheeks, boys. This is going to be very, very close indeed. Oh, he just about got it. Cajunb clutches the round out of thin air and gives TSM their second round. But I've got to say, E-Frag, what the hell was that? It's a 2-on-2, and it effectively ended up being a 2-2v1s for no reason. Butts were clenched that day. That was super close. So, is that the moment where TSM start to wake up from their slumber? They've looked a bit suspect the last few days. Bit of an upset, a lot of people would say, at DreamHack Winter in Yongshipping. A Luminosity Shrek'd them. Look at this. I was just about to say, there is a lot of movement from the terrorists over on the B side. Dupreeh did hold his ground for one kill, but is that even good enough? Bomb is being planted once more. It's going to be action here in mid. Spyleader spins round, lands the shot, and this now forces the rest of the CTs to really keep in the back of their mind that Spyleader could be coming from behind. So this pretty much stops them from aggressing on the site to start off with. That's the importance of a lurker. Even if you don't end up wrecking their entire team, if you just get one frag, that can put enough doubt in your enemy to keep them at bay. And TSM again just pull themselves back. They bite the bullet, cut their losses, keep three weapons alive. So E-Frag, again, have just cancelled the round loss bonus from TSM. You can see that two players only on $1,700 and will be buying. And there wasn't even enough funds for the rest of TSM either to drop for them. So it is going to be a Deagle, a 5.7 with armor, and the three aforementioned weapons from the last round, which are the AWP and the two M4s, the A4 and the A1S respectively. So again, TSM, this is not great by any stretch of the imagination, but at least there are weapons to play with. And E-Frag's economy just keeps building. I don't think there's going to be a single round where E-Frag are in a force buy or an eco for the rest of this half. It's pretty much going to be AKs for the rest of this. So up catwalk, the T's do progress through. Zipnex and Bubble chime with the first frags. Cajunb with a Deagle. We know he's capable of craziness from here. Lands the headshot. Half through smoke as well. Very crisp execution on that frag. Excellent work from him. That also drops the bomb. So it delays the push just a few more seconds. Victor's been picked off over on the B side. Bomb is being planted now. And TSM have to come up with something special. We have seen 3v2 clutches already go the way of E-Frag. Bubble has this one perfectly locked down, but he actually misses the shot. He's going to pull out the Deagle. And then the AWP does land that one perfectly. Spins back around again. Going to keep on his perspective, because he really is the man that could just lock this one off by himself. And now there's absolutely no hope for Zipnex. He has a kit. Oh, Bubble's missed a couple of shots there. Zipnex still hasn't started defusing. What is going on? Bubble clutches it with 3 HP. I don't even. My brain. Well, there you go. It doesn't have to make sense. A win is a win. And E-Frag now 10-2 with TSM on Eco. And spyleadeR's going to be taking the MAC 10. And why the hell not? It's very good against Eco players. You can just charge on in. If you end up dying, it's not the end of the world. It's a cheap weapon. Doesn't do much damage to armored targets, so it's a pretty solid pickup here from spyleadeR. I like that a lot. Reading the situation perfectly, as you'd hope your leader would. Device, looking for the frag. spyleadeR, though, is up to the task with the MAC-10. Delivers not just one, but two fatal blows, and only loses minimal damage in the process. spyleadeR is still charging in for more. Meanwhile, dupreeh trying to hold on to the site. The smoke spam comes through. And E-Frag do not lose a single player in round 13. 11-2 score now. I really feel TSM have to get 11-4 if they want to keep in. Like I've been saying consistently, it's early days. TSM can bounce back. But if TSM go into the second half at like 12-3, 13-2, I think that's a bridge way too far. As suspect as E-Frag's CT side is a lot of the time, I feel like they're good for at least two or three rounds. So, honestly, 11-4 may not even be enough. At least that gives them a chance if they win the pistol. That grenade does quite a bit of damage to MKL down to 67. karrigan could be crucial to TSM's hold. Gonna be players coming up to his location. cajunb gets the flash out. That's perfectly timed. One frag is picked up. cajunb wasn't hungry for the second. Greed is not always good in that sense. And now karrigan is the other part of the puzzle over on long. Can he do what cajunb just was able to pick off himself? There's the first one, looking for a second as well. Picks up two frags and he's still alive somehow in this encounter. Bubble just peeks around the corner. Finally puts him down. Too little too late as far as E-Frag are concerned though. And now it's also so important that TSM keep these four weapons alive for their economy. If they lose another two players in this, it would have been a pretty solid job. And they actually do end up losing more players. A Molotov kill and the AK-47 take TSM down to two players. And this is what I'm talking about right now. They're going to be able to drop. Let's see what their grenade situation is like. I think everyone's going to have a weapon. But I feel like their nades may be hurt as a result here. So karrigan's going to have no nades, just a smoke and a flashbang on device. So nades, not great. Only the one incendiary for TSM. And hashtag roasted is correct. Important to mention though, guys, this is E-Frag's choice of map. What the hell is going on there? Can you see that? And like mid to top of the screen, just like guns floating in the air. Okay, you go, TV. Throw some more bugs at me. Come at me, bro. I can deal with them. We've had the no HP. We've had smoke bugs. We've had random guns in the air. What else have you got for us? NKL. How do you deal with that? He just runs out and wrecks a player by himself. There's Device and karrigan, though, putting down the hammer by himself. That will funnel in the T's onto the A side. And there's Zipnex. So finally, it seems like TSM are putting some kills together. That smoke's not ideal from E-Frag. Bomb has been picked up only momentarily, though. As down goes spyleadeR. Bubble now, your last remaining E-Frag player. 30 seconds left on the timer. Pushing up through short. We'll be able to get his hands on the bomb. But of course, that really is only a small part of the problem. He's also going to plant this for sure. This is incredibly ballsy. The flashbang comes over. They line up for him, but he can't get it done. And TSM will lock down their fourth round. But again, is four rounds going to be enough? The pistol is absolutely crucial. Nichev. They say TSM's the best Dust2 player. Dust2, I would say, is definitely TSM's. I feel TSM are one of the best teams, if not the best team on this map. I just think it's an off day for them. Right, one sec. You're asking me to turn the game sound up. There we go. How does that work for you? Let's go. You didn't miss anything. Don't picnic in chat, please. But here come TSM again, right for the jugular. Such an important, crucial round. It seems that they are getting things their way so far. Dreamer lands the headshot through the smoke on cajunb. It could just be a drop in the ocean, though. But still, that does hurt TSM. Bomb. He's going to get planted. Here comes the cavalry from E-Frag. They're picking up kills here, there, and everywhere. Zip next on the site. It's all on dupreeh. He's landed one frag. He's looking for a second. He gets that one as well, but he can't get any more. And Dreamer is going to get his mitts on the bomb site, and he will defuse this for E-Frag. And that is a body blow, to say the least, for TSM. The retake is real. Let me know if the game sound needs to be turned up a tad bit more, guys. Thanks for the feedback again. Appreciate it. Here we go. E-Frag. TSM, do you have a pretty decent helping of weapons, and this is almost a desperation play, I feel, from them, like, really going all in on this round. They've got two AKs, they've got themselves a scout, a deagle, and a P250, and that's a pretty crucial first frag as well from Device, landing the headshot. Nice return, though, from Viktor. Lands the three-pointer from downtown. Another grenade goes in, doing a lot of damage. I did mention before that when two players don't have Kevlar, you'll be surprised at how much damage those grenades actually inflict. And again, TSM claim the first kill. They get first blood. And then just everything goes against them. E-Frag come out with a vengeance. Only lose spyleadeR in that round. 13-4. Let's have a look at the score. How is it going for both teams? So top fragging is spyleadeR. And this is no disrespect to spyleadeR, but he's definitely not the guy that you're thinking is the carry bags. He's not the star player for E-Frag. He's their in-game leader. Normally, you're expecting to see Viktor, Bubble, Dreamer maybe, top fragging. So spyleadeR is leading by example. He is just putting his foot down. On the side of TSM, no one's necessarily playing too terribly. It's just the case that no one's necessarily playing too well. It's been kind of mediocre from them today. SpyleadeR win the MP9. Looking for more frags. Tap, tap, tap. Sounds a bit like a pea shooter, but against armor, it is incredibly strong. And he's just landed himself another one through smoke. You can see there that dupreeh, Device, both down to sub 25 HP. Make that 0 HP as E-Frag take a 10-round lead and are just too shy of picking up their choice of map in convincing fashion. So at the start of this, I was like, guys, do you think that E-Frag could even get close to winning a map? Most people were saying no. And it shows now that at the worst-case scenario, E-Frag are going to have at least 14 rounds on this half, and indeed this map. And I feel this map is theirs. I cannot see how TSM bounce back from this. As good as they are, I just can't see it happening. TSM pushing up along. No one is home from E-Frag. So maybe. That smoke, though, slightly off, and that allows Bubble to land. Not just one scout shot, but two. And again, it just goes to show that CS is a matter of millimeters at times. If a smoke slightly misses, it really can be the difference between winning and losing. Imagine that smoke lands now. TSM will pull across onto the site altogether, and they'd have a perfect post-plant defense set up. As it stands, they're a player behind. Device is there, hungry for frags. One has been dropped from dupreeh, looking for more here. Lands a second. This is much better from TSM, and they do close it out. But man, oh man, TSM are not filling me with confidence. Kasta, I am Metis. Hello. Hope you're having a good night. Hope you're enjoying the action. I think a lot of people are a bit sweaty right now, as they probably bet on TSM. Molotov lands in long. Doesn't really do any damage. In fact, I think he did like 5 damage to dupreeh. Hello, GoTV. Hello. There we go. It's working again. Oh my goodness, Viktor. He's having a field day. He's managed to survive as well. Goes back for seconds and lands a third. What is going on, TSM? This is normally where I'd be like, so, co-caster, analyze what's going wrong. And I feel like you'd probably say, I have no idea. TSM are just getting absolutely wrecked. It's all ogre now. The Shrekening is real. Over with the first kill. Almost playing for pride at this point at TSM. 16-5 is... that's a crushing defeat by any standards. But especially when you're strong favourites coming into this game, to lose 16-5 would be horrendous. So they are playing for pride. Playing for a bit of confidence, maybe, going through into that second map of Overpass. And again, I said it before, E-Frag are not a bad Overpass team. On paper, Dust2 and Overpass, probably two of E-Frag's best maps. I think Cash would probably be in there as well. Inferno is not bad for them either, so third map of Inferno, they wouldn't be too bothered about that. But can they close this map out? Let's not get too far ahead of ourselves. It's looking likely. And there we go. Device is going to get picked off. The retaliation coming in from TSM. Desperately trying to body bag E-Frag, but they're just going in one by one against the Deagle. With a Deagle, I should say. Against an AWP is never the greatest of ideas. And unfortunately, they didn't have any other options. The E-Frag are going to take the first map 16-5. How surprising is that, chat? Unbelievable. I would never have expected a scoreline of that magnitude for E-Frag. Maybe for TSM, but not for E-Frag. So, I don't know, man. That's pretty brutal for TSM. We will be moving to the dusty plains of... well, I said dusty plains. Overpass has a bit of dust, but definitely not dusty plains. What I'm wondering about. I think it's a German map. So we'll be moving to Germany next for Overpass. There is a bank there, so maybe TSM can go rob it or something, get themselves some funds to buy more weapons. I have no idea. I'm at a loss for words right now, guys. So anyway, I'm going to cut some music. We're going to go for a quick break here. I suggest you get yourself a drink, some food. I definitely am going to be myself, as I'm solo casting. It's quite taxing for the old vocal cords. So when you rejoin us, it'll be live for Overpass. I'm kind of, I don't know what to say. TSM just got completely destroyed.